More wild weather has lashed Victoria. Melbourne and other parts of the state have been hit by torrential rain, lightning and thunder for a third straight day. A severe thunderstorm last night smashed Geelong. Streets there were awash after 30 millimetres of rain fell in just 20 minutes. Some local businesses forced to close until the damage can be cleaned up.
And in Geelong, the wild weather didn't stop this guy from sticking to his weekly routine. So we're in the middle of a big storm.
Needs a bit of a trim.
It wasn't even very long.
He was just getting ahead of the game because he's sitting there seeing that torrential rain thing. This grass is going to explode.
He's going to love the rain.
Yeah.
My theory is that is a man in the middle of an argument with his girlfriend. That is extreme sulking. That's what I think is going on there.
All right, to some other much sadder news now. Australia has recorded one of its deadliest days of the pandemic. 98 people have died from COVID. The number includes 39 deaths in Victoria. New South Wales reported 35 fatalities, as well as 35 historical deaths from this month in aged care. And on the vaccine front tonight, Pfizer has been approved as a booster for 16 and 17-year-olds.
And Kanye West may have met his match. The AFL, which owns Marvel Stadium, has reportedly refused to move the St Kilda Collingwood game on March 18 to accommodate his touring schedule. Word is he wanted to do a show there a few days later, but despite his star power, the AFL is refusing to alter its round one fixture. Yay needs to realise in Victoria, footy comes first.
Oh, I think in Victoria, they're all a bit traumatised by having the AFL Grand Final move to Perth for the first time in however many years, that they're just, like, clinging on to every match. They're not moving it for Jesus. They're not moving it for Jesus. They're not moving it for anybody.
Oh, God, Jesus is going to be there.
Probably, if he makes his comeback, who knows?
I've got an idea of how we deal with this Kanye situation. I think we should tell him the gig's on, it's all going ahead, then we wait for him to arrive in Australia, then we deport him.
Oh!
It was fine last time.
You know what? I don't think he's declared his vaccine status.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
We could be up for round two.
You heard it here first.
Yeah,
otherwise, Jeff and starting okay, some wild old rumours.
Yeah,
Jesus is going to show up. We're going to deport Kanye.
All right, moving on now. And a new finding has emerged from one of the world's largest studies into clinical depression. Researchers have identified another 23 specific genes associated with a person's risk of developing the condition. It's hoped the discovery will lead to more tailored and effective treatments.
This really shows that depression does have biological causes, just like, you know, heart disease or cancer, and that the more of these genes that you have, the more likely you are to have depression.
And apparently there's a reason we're all mesmerised by cleaning hacks and pantry organisation videos on social media. One psychologist says it's because they have a calming effect on our brains. She says watching someone with a solution, even for just a cleaning problem, can ease our own anxieties. You know what I reckon it is? Seeing someone else do the cleaning, not you. It's really that simple.
So you don't think people like watching videos of themselves cleaning?
No, definitely not. I tell you what I do like is, you know those videos of how to fold a fitted sheet?
No.
So it goes in the cupboard like a proper, just a normal flat sheet?
Go on.
I admit, my name is Lisa Wilkinson and I'm addicted to that.
What is your algorithm, Lisa
Well,
Wilkinson?
It's just, they've always baffled me. And when I see someone do that job superbly...
Do you feel good?
No, I just admire them. Martha Stewart does those really well. So does Oprah.
Can I give you a hot tip, Javran? Never, ever ask Lisa Wilkinson about octopus videos on the internet, because you'll disappear for days.
Yeah, I clicked on one recently and then the internet decided I love octopus videos. And every time I go on my Instagram, there's an octopus video.
I told you.
Am I to understand that when you're home at night scrolling, you're looking at people folding fitted sheets and octopi?
Sad.
Oh, my God.